in our Nexa journey. As you all know, Nexa was conceived to translate its key values into a custom-crafted quality experience for the constantly connected, more demanding urban metropolitan consumers of today. These informed, evolved, and aspirational consumers have bespoke tastes. They have a love for global trends and are constantly seeking new. The Nexa brand philosophy of create, inspire stems from these seekers of new. Their passion fuels innovation. Their imagination fuels the fit. Nexa, we create to inspire this creativity. In our cars, our service, our hospitality at the showroom, and in all other Nexa experiences that customer has with us. The urban metropolitan customer is passionate about his lifestyle, his travel, and most importantly, his music. Today, music has become a universal language. It goes beyond the barriers of age, language, borders, and geographies. In fact, music is now very commonly and indeed very impactfully used by brands to connect with its consumers. The Nexa consumers have a love for global music. They are very passionate about their music and following global hits and chart toppers, as well as constantly exploring the various artists and genres. We at Nexa believe that India has the potential to create original international music that is of global standards. The Nexa music is that next step in the Nexa journey of create, inspire. Who better to lead this project than the man who has become an inspiration, a global icon to millions of people in India and abroad? The man who has redefined how the world sees Indian music, and indeed, who has seamlessly made Indian music global, Mr. A.R. Rahman. Friends,
welcome, Clinton. Hey, how are you today?
My mic seems off. Oh, actually, it's on, but I can't hear you too well.
Yeah, you can't hear me too.
Yeah,
well.
I can't hear you too well for some reason.
Okay, maybe the proximity is too close.
Okay.
Next, I would like to invite on stage one of the most influential musicians in India, the founder, the creative force, and the front man of India's front-running rock band, Indus Creed, Uday Benegal. Yeah, Uday, you can sit wherever you want. Next, I want to invite on stage singer, songwriter, model, VJ, actress, a dear friend, and one of my most favorite people on earth, I think, Anushka Manchanda. This next invitation is of great honor for me to be even saying. I would like to call upon stage someone who's been on the list of the 100 most influential people in the world. He's been awarded the Padma Bhushan, 2 Grammys, 6 National Film Awards, and 15 Filmfare Awards. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for the Mozart of Madras, the one and only A.R. Rahman.
Thank you.
And I would also like to call upon stage Mr. Tarun Garg, the Executive Director of Marketing, Maruti Suzuki India. Big round of applause, please. And now, to take this panel discussion forward, the Managing Director and CEO of QQ Digital Media and the force behind this one. I'll leave you to it, Sameer. Thank you, Sarah.
Thanks so much. Thank you all for being here. Thank you so much for this amazing opportunity to. And path-breaking, I have to say that you know, we did our research. We do so much in music. And what we realized is that. This is actually path-breaking, because if you put your mind to it, in the recent past, at least I can't come up with it, there has been no project that has actually supported. There just hasn't been any platform, any brand that has stood behind that and given it or any independent artist a skill that you will come about to see as we discuss this today. I wanted to quickly open with maybe Tarun-san. Give us an idea on the genesis and the thought behind Nexa Music and how this all came about, because you know, you are the pioneers in this space, so please tell us about it.
Look, ever since we have launched the Nexa channel in 2015, you know, we have always believed in doing something new. And if you see today, the philosophy of Nexa is like create and inspire. And we have been in various genres, and now we decided, why not independent music? You know, the whole idea was, can we take the experience of the customer beyond the showroom? And we have seen that independent music, you know, it is gaining traction. In fact, you know, in 2002, I believe it really contributed only 3% to the total music, but now I believe it's bordering around 25%. So there are a whole lot of enthusiastic people who are really interested in international music. And the other aspect is that you know, there is no really real platform where people who want to create music, you know, they can come and show us their passion. So I think this is a great opportunity for these people, that beyond Bollywood or beyond you know, Hindi music, something new comes up.
Absolutely.
And that is the whole idea behind Nexa going into independent music. Yeah.
Thank you, Mr. Rahman. Or Rahman-san, for the occasion, I'll refer to you as Rahman-san. You know, I know that we've discussed so many projects, but you're especially excited about this. I've seen you leaning forward, coming up with ideas. In this vast career that you've had and rich career that you've had, what do you think has been the, what can we do different over here? I mean, this English, the opportunity to give talent from India to create original English music, why hasn't that happened so far?
First of all, there's no screens for the expression. There's nobody commissioning you to do a particular thing, but it's what you feel and what stories you're going to say through your song. And nothing defines, so you have to be Indian or you need to be, so you can put it out to the world. Like K-pop has taken over. After that hit number, they've just taken pride and pushed it up, and now it's become like a mainstream name. K-pop is a mainstream name. But unfortunately, with J-Ho, it never happened. I think it has to be a collective revolution. You know, one single person can't do it. It has to be collective, and the whole country has to rise up.
Right.
And so in a way, film music did it, but I felt like disappointed because indie music, there's so many, it was brewing for the past 10 years. I could see that a lot of underground music, a lot of indie musicians who come in, but they were just, the views, if you see, it'll be 100,000 or 200,000.
Right.
And so the exposure, somebody like Nexa Music coming in it is really good. I can see the enthusiasm in the brand doing
absolutely
something. It's a great start, right?
Okay, Clinton, as the music producer on the project, and you know, we considered many names, and I think just your prolific career and your association with English music, and of course, you know, you've had a body of work in Bollywood, Coke Studio, all of the other stuff, and a great career in ads, but it stood out as a producer who can actually help some of the talent actually reach out to global audiences. Tell us a little bit about your journey in considering being associated with this, and how do you think we will create a slightly differentiated sound? Sometimes you might have to inspire some of the other creators and step back and let them create it and actually just give it the finishing touch, and sometimes maybe do some of the heavy lifting with them. Because what we certainly want is a sound that is borderless and that can travel across the world, but originated from India. Tell us about your thoughts around that.
Actually, I completely agree with what AR said to begin with, and why I'm so excited to be associated with Nexa to begin with is that in India, we don't have a pop industry. We have a film industry, and we as musicians service the film industry. So what happens is, even though we are creating music that is heard by millions of people, that is not necessarily our own expression. It's what a director wants us to create for a situation. It's what a film demands. So it's not always our own expression. This is a blank page. We have a blank canvas, and we can create our own expression as artists, which is something to be really grateful for as an indie musician in a country which is very strongly driven by Bollywood. So that's the first point. Coming to the second point of how I see the project, I think that it's very, very important for us to look at India on the global stage, just as AR sir said about the K-pop industry. I don't think they consider themselves anything less than the US market or the UK Absolutely. Market, and that's how they've managed to succeed. So I think we have to have that same vision. That's at least I personally have that same vision. I think that we are going to create sounds that are unique, sounds that are definitive, but are in no way less than anything you would hear on the Billboard, top 100 or, anything like that. And also, I mean, for the way I'm seeing each of these artists, like each of these artists have so much personality in their own right. Like you've heard Nikhil before. I don't think there's any, young Indian who hasn't heard any of them already. You know, they're such brilliant musicians in their own right. But how do we, present Anushka in a way that people haven't heard of before? How do we present Uday in a slightly different way that people have, who are, or at least his fans, haven't seen him before? How do we present Nikhil in a way that Nikhil's fan base hasn't, connected with him in a way? I mean, I think that's how I'm also looking at trying to create something a little different, but at the same time give the fans, what they're used to. The familiarity also, should be there.
No, I hear Raman-san talk about magic. We have to create the magic. So hopefully you'll bring some of that pixie dust on everybody's work. You came out of a talent hunt back in the day, right? It's been, when was it? The 2002? And you were the original Viva girl, right? Yes. Now, tell us a little bit about how that's shaped your career. Because part of this is discovering an interesting sound and a band that's really talented. But what can we do different as part of Nexa Music that we actually make sure that we nurture the talent, not just for the part of a hunt, but about the journey after that? And, just from the various conversations we've had, this has taken a while. What I saw with the brand, one is that they're bold to attempt this because it's an open space, right? We're not looking at it just to look at the numbers, but they've always had a long association. And we did our research and we said, okay, 5 years with IFA, with India's Got Talent, because you don't want somebody to back something like this in its early days and then step out of it because it didn't get the right sort of, scale of it. So I love that about the brand and about Nexa Music and giving this opportunity. How would you sort of connect the dots back to the indie scene, English original music?
I think it's really important for an artist to be developed, and here with this project, all the expertise is being provided to this artist. Usually with reality shows and contests and things like this, an artist is brought out onto the scene, with a big bang, and a video is made, and then that's it. And the artist is left to fend for himself or herself, to make decisions without any experience and any knowledge. And I think with this project, the fact that it's going to be a long-term project, they're looking at stage performance, they're looking at, Absolutely. Brand building for the artist. It's really important for the development and growth of the artist, So it's not just a flash in the pan, it's actually something more long-lasting and meaningful. And for me as an artist, this is really important, Like a whole 360 as opposed to like just a flash in the pan.
Awesome. So. Uday, I want to. There were some interesting stories that we were sharing, this morning when I was sitting with Nikhil and Uday, and what came up is You know, Uday, you spent 9 years. You actually left Bombay at the peak of your career when Indiscreet was, you know, the only scene. Growing up, this was the hottest band in town, right? We're letting go of revealing a little bit of age here, but that's fine. I'm 44 too. But then you went to New York and you spent 9 years in New York. Why did you do that, and how did that impact your career? And is that advice that you would actually give budding musicians to actually do that?
The advice I would give any budding musician is don't look to me for any inspiration. I do things because I feel it's the right thing to do in that moment, whether it makes financial, economic, logistical sense or not. I don't think about the consequences of that. I deal with the consequences of that later.
Spoken like a true artist.
Yeah. Well, it's the reason why I became a rock musician to begin with, singing in English in a country that at the time there was nothing. It's because I love to do it. And I think that's the thing that I think anybody who wants to express themselves in whichever way, whether it's through music or any other form, do it because you love to do it. So, yeah, I mean, I left and I moved to New York because things were moving in the independent music scene in this country in a way that wasn't really inspiring me in any way, wasn't engaging for me in any way. And I wanted, as I said to you earlier, I needed a cultural shot in the arm, and New York was the place for me to get it. I wanted to immerse myself amongst people who had incredible talent that I could look to and try and find myself up to their levels of expertise in all forms, as songwriters, as performers, as people who present themselves in various ways. I mean, those were my motivations, and it worked for me. It did affect my career in many ways because things that I had been that were established for me in India at that point. You neglect something for too long and it goes away.
Right.
But that's okay because I got something else from it. I got an exposure to a lot of things about making music, about not just about music. I mean, for me, my music is fed by many things. It's not fed only by music alone. As a songwriter, I can only write songs, I believe, that can only get better or could be more truthful if I experience more in this world and experience more from my life. And that was part of it for me. So those are my reasons for going there. And I would say, do whatever would, I mean, follow your heart, really. I mean, it sounds cliche, but it's true.
Right. I mean, so part of the idea of having, you know, all of you, starting with Mr. Rahman, as a mentor collaborator, and we've done projects with him where when he gets his hands dirty, he gets involved in it. You know, Clinton, likewise, you don't sort of look at it just from a topical, to, you know, 30,000 foot level. And that was the idea to sort of actually come back. Not every person might have the opportunity to sort of, you know, move out of the country. Could we give them a slice of that inspiration from all of you put together and give them that exposure as rapidly as possible? But, you know, we've got an entire year. So a year over here. Nikhil, your experience in the UK, does that define you? Did that define you as an artist? Was your inclination to move out also to the UK for a couple of years to sort of get that cultural injection? Isn't there enough of that here, or do we not have enough next up projects floating around?
Well, I think for me, that journey began somewhere in 2013 when it was suggested to me that I should try and work with other songwriters outside the country. And it so happened I went to Nashville. I started writing with one of the songwriters over there. And we wrote about 5 songs in a week and made songwriting demos for it. And when I came back, there was an album I had worked on over here, which I didn't release because it had kind of moved beyond that point. And every time, if you put an album out, you kind of commit to a sound for 2 years. Right. So it just changed everything for me. And then got signed in the UK in 2016. But what that did was it got me to work with, you know, the songwriters in the UK circuit, producers in the UK circuit. And I was finally hearing the songs that were in my head sounding like what I hear on the radio out in the UK and in the US. So that's, for me, what the biggest takeaway was to, you know, get that validation.
Right. Okay. Yeah. Awesome. Rahman-san, is there a dearth of talent in English music? Or do we just not give it an opportunity? Like, for example, songwriting. Do you think as we open up the hunt today, we're going to be challenged by the numbers? Is it about the numbers? Do we need 5,000 people to apply, or we need those 10 really amazing artists to come in and reach out to us? Have you found a dearth of talent in songwriting is the specific question.
I think first having a platform and to give that empowerment, saying that you will be heard, because without all these doubts coming in, okay, will my, you know, I know that I can write well, but that confidence actually gives people, make them write better. And so that's a good step one. I don't think there's any doubt of, because every kid who wants to do music, they want to do something other than Indian stuff. They want to do it in English. Indian stuff. They want to do outworldly stuff. So the outworldly is out, you know, the other side, Western side.
Right.
And not because it's English or Western, because they feel like they're aiming at a higher level of thing. Not that we don't have higher level of things, but it is a, you know, when you're young, even I used to listen to only, you know, Western classical and Western rock and Western, you know, pop songs and all this stuff. So in a way, you learn and then you give it back here. But now it's an interesting culmination of what we are and what we could become in the international, you know, platform.
Right. Okay.
What was your question?
No. So the dearth on songwriting. So yeah, I think you've answered that, that there isn't really a dearth, yeah, but we haven't given the platforms to sort of...
Yeah, because I think we have so much Eastern ideology and Eastern wisdom, which people nick from here. And we can see that in many movies it's been taken. But right, we don't do it. Like yoga comes back to us.
Right.
And you see all the yoga. And like
yes.
So I think it's the right time to say that, no, we're going to own it. It's us, and this is us, you know?
Do you think we need to have a Western sound, or lyrically also we should be actually writing in English and sort of, or do we just create a Western sound to local language lyrics?
I think it's art. You have to become that art. You have to, you know, it's not about what instrument you use. You play that and you feel like it's right.
Right.
I think people have come to that level, you know, transcend all these technicalities about what instrument to use, what words to use. But when you hear it, you know that, man, this is different.
Right. Awesome. So one of the things that I learned is, I'm no music aficionado, but I love the business of music. And we were traveling in a car one day, and he said, you should listen to music with your eyes closed. And if you ever notice him, whenever he's appreciating music or listening to music or trying to pick it, he listens to it, even if there's a music video, with his eyes closed. So that's a great tip. And I think that's where if the connect, I think, is what you're talking about, whether it's written in Hindi or English or whether it's a Western sound, the music's got to connect, and that's going to be our goal. So, Clinton, again, from the live experiences that we program, because we program a bunch of live experiences, and feel free to jump in, you know, Uday, Anushka, Nikhil, how important is that to mold an artist? We're packaging the artist, we're giving them a platform, we're giving them exposure to incredible mentor collaborators. How important is the live aspect of this?
I think it's extremely important in today's time. I mean, there was a time when the Beatles actually stopped touring because they really couldn't hear themselves perform because the fans were screaming louder than them. So they actually stopped touring because of that. But that was a time when they could actually make money from just selling the albums. I don't think we have that that luxury anymore. I think an artist really has to support their music by touring, by performing live, which is why building your personality is as important as just building your oral personality. You're building your oral personality by, you know, what comes out on tape, what comes out in your albums. But at the same time, your visual personality, the way you reach out, the way you communicate, is obviously going to matter the most in today's time, because I think those are the artists that are well-rounded, and those are the artists.
Yeah, I would like to add, like, build a community where they're all pushing for higher ideals in music, in thoughts. So, you know, that actually enhances the whole experience. It's not just talking about the same thing which you've been doing, yeah, but, you know, like Bob Dylan songs, or, you know,
right,
keep the highest level of intellect and words which trigger imagination.
Right.
In the music and the words. I think that would be a good way to start. I think.
But at the same time, I think that if you're trying to reach a younger audience, we have to try and make it relatable as
both.
Well.
Both, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I think, Anushka, did you have to work on your look as a visual hammer to build your brand identity? Is something that you were, that when you decided that you're going to become an artist, a pop star, did you have to really take that up? Did that come to you naturally, Uday? Did you have to, you know, when did you decide that it should be four earrings on the left ear and one on the right? Or did that all this happen naturally?
I think when when I actually started singing, I was thrown into this, you know, this industry, and at that time, everything was planned for us, you know, the way that we look, what we wore. It wasn't necessarily what I felt, like an extension of my personality, but it was a look that was being presented. It was a pop band that was being presented. Now I can say, like over the years as an artist, I heard many things from people, you know, oh, if you're on stage and performing, you should dress this way because everyone dresses this way. You know, you have to wear heels on stage, or you have to wear like really shiny dresses or gowns. And I tried it, you know, and at the end of the day, I realized that it's not me. And as an artist, what you wear, how you look, is an extension of your art because you are presenting yourself.
Precisely, yeah.
And that's important. So I think now I'm comfortable, you know, I am comfortable in my skin, and I say that I am who I am, you know. If I want to get on stage like this, I will. But it is with thought. It's not like getting up from the bed and being like, okay, I'm just going to go to a show like this because I don't care. I care. And I think it's important for an artist to care, because it is really the whole package, especially with social media, and everyone has a phone and a video. It's, you are being presented to the world always in a full package.
Right.
So it's important.
Right. Uday? How important is it, the visual hammer? How important is it?
What made me decide to get three earrings in one and one in the other? Okay. So the thing is, as far back as I can remember, it's also been a part of my nature to want to thumb my nose at the establishment. I don't mean that in a way of seeking attention, though there is part of that as well. As all of us who get on stage, we seek attention. I personally do. I love the applause of an audience.
As a performer, you must, yes. To make a point, you must.
But the thing is, it's never going to work unless you are yourself. So
right.
Going by what AR said and what Clinton said and what Anushka said, it really is all of what they said, which is you have to aspire for the highest ideal. You have to be yourself, and you've got to be able to present it in a way. It's only going to work on stage. Of course, you've got to be good at your craft. You've got to be a tight band. You've got to be a great singer, whatever it is that you do. But you have to be yourself. You have to be honest. So music for me is about truth and love. You've got to love what you do, and you've got to be absolutely honest about how you do it. So you've got to be able to be as good as you can be, because you'll feel better about yourself.
Sure.
And the way you present yourself, it will never work if it's just a calculation. So the three earrings and one the other was not a calculation. That's just how I am.
Awesome.
That's all I can say.
And Nikhil,
I got my first tattoo only about 6 years ago, by the way. I didn't have a tattoo all my life.
Okay.
So it was only when I was ready for it. So you've got to be ready for it, and then you do it, and then you stick with it.
And Nikhil, your music is, you know, you've got this easy breezy look. Your music, when you listen to it, sort of, I mean, so I think what I'm picking up is really, you've got to look the part of the music that you're creating.
Yeah, I think, you know, the most important thing though is, you know, if you're looking comfortable on stage when you're singing and you're performing, and it's, you're not thinking about what you're wearing. That is obviously the first thing. But then in terms of, you know, a look perspective, you probably need to be consistent also.
Are you married?
Am I married?
Yeah.
No, I'm not married.
So yeah, I had long till I got married.
Yeah, if you're talking about the long hair, I've had long hair since my college days.
Well, enjoy it till you get married, then that's the underlying message.
No, not even close, not even close.
Okay.
Yeah. Right.
Long, I had long hair after I was married, actually.
Yeah. Dom's a fantastic
I
wife.
I grew my hair after I got married.
So, very quickly, maybe we can start with you, Nikhil. What is the one thing that you're really looking forward to with the Nexa Music project? And Tarun San, I want to come to you to sort of round off before you can then announce the opening of the hunt, so to speak. And so that's what I just want to hear from all of you. What is the one thing that you're looking forward to from the Nexa Music project?
Well, for me, it all comes down to an artist level. You know, I find there's going to be amazing songwriters somewhere in the country. And for me, it's exciting to see what, you know, a small town, a kid somewhere has to say about life, about love, about anything. Of course, the next step is putting them in a studio and getting a performance out of them. And then with Nexa, putting it out there to millions of people, which is the opportunity they haven't had so far. So I'm looking forward to just hearing some great songs on a personal level.
So your focus is going to be on selecting the talent that writes incredible songwriters.
Songs that you can hear 50 years from now. For me, that's my personal benchmark, you know, for anything, for any songs. Yeah.
Let's hope we find that Sheeran somewhere there. Uday.
Well, it's kind of an extension of what Nikhil said. I feel exactly the same way. I'm very much looking forward to listening to somebody who has something original to say. And when I say original, it doesn't mean that it has never been said before, but something that is truth, honest, and just great to listen to.
Awesome. Anushka?
As an artist, I feel like you have to always keep learning and always keep growing. And sometimes I feel like, you know, because I like a certain kind of music, like if I like drum and bass, then I listen to a lot of drum and bass. I listen to a lot of the music that I like. And I think, besides what these gentlemen have said, I think this will be an opportunity for us to learn too, you know, to hear new sound and to see what's up, actually, because there's so much new music in the world, and in our country with billions of people, there's so much talent. Like, I can't wait to see what's going to happen. I can't wait to learn, you know, more.
Awesome. And the great thing, ladies and gentlemen, is apart from, you know, sourcing or finding this amazing songwriters, people who are speaking on the heart and saying original things, you're also going to be hearing original English music coming from all of these amazing talented artists. So in addition to the, you know, four incredible original tracks that are going to be coming from these incredible artists, Clinton, you think? You've got to step in and sort of, like I said, you know, throw that pixie dust, and not only with the young upcoming artists, but also how you collaborate with everybody, you know, over here. Are you excited?
Yeah, I was just talking to Kalsi-san and Tarun-san in the meeting room back there, and I was saying that when we get those entries, there's going to be a lot of stuff that we're going to be hearing, you know, because I think everybody's got this thing that they're going to just, you know, burst out and, you know, just finally there's an English platform. Here you go. You know, because I don't think there's ever been something like this. So we are going to have our work cut out for us in terms of, I mean, personally, I'm really going to have to really start being selective with what's going to actually go into the lab, because I think there's going to be a lot out there, and there's going to be a lot of at various levels.
Right.
So I really want to make sure that we actually get the best of what this country has to offer.
Yeah, the thing is, when we, most of the artists, you know, they have an original side of them. I think it's to kindle that and bring that part of it, and then probably reduce the influences, what they have, and bring the originality out.
Get the original out, okay. So, speaking of which, you know, I think these incredible artists out of their homes to kind of
questions. Please mention your publication before you answer. Before you ask your question.
Hello. Good afternoon, sir. Rehman sir here. What is the idea behind Nexa Music?
The idea is to promote indie music in India, indie English music. And they've always been like an underdog. And I personally heard many amazing songs on YouTube. And I feel like with this encouragement and this investment of Nexa Music and indie artists, I think it's going to shine.
So can you tell me the criteria of this? What's going to be criteria and how the selection will be done?
Samir? We need Samir.
There's an entire sort of detailed process. We're happy to share that with you as part of the press kit, perhaps offline. But basically, entries will be taken on nexamusic.com, and we have you saw the panel of artists that we have on board. They're going to review all of that content and then pick 24 incredible bands that are creating original English music. And those 24 bands will then, four will be selected from that, who will actually collaborate with the mentors and create four additional videos. The mentors themselves are also creating videos, so you'll have 32 original soundtracks coming from these 24 artists that we are going to be curating. More details, happy to share with you.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. Rehman, will it be online, or you will take auditions like on your right? Yeah.
Samir, I think we need you on stage as a permanent fixture.
Yeah, I think you're asking all the hard questions to the artists. The artists are meant to create. So all the hard questions can come to us. Yes, so we're going to be largely driving this initiative online. And the idea for that is to sort of, I think the internet democratizes selection of talent. Yeah. So, and we're also going to be doing a bunch of live events from the curated talent. So you might have some really interesting surprises that we are working with Nexa and Nexa Music to perhaps enhance the experience of how we consume. You heard Mr. Rahman say that one of the key challenges of discovering music is venues. And so we're seeing if we can actually tackle that in an interesting way. It's going to be online in terms of selection process, and then also give the artists an opportunity to perform live through the year. So you will see 12 live gigs that will emerge as part of the Nexa Music project.
And Mr. Rahman, how will it be beneficial for the artists, especially singers or musicians? What?
Exposure mainly. And we're not telling many things here because we don't want to promise too much and not deliver. But the whole idea is to, this is the first step. The second step is something we are working on, is to give them the exposure for them in the international playground. And that's not easy because there's so many factors stopping that. So the first step is this, and I'm very, very pleased with this step.
Yeah, Mr. Rahman. I'd like to wish you many happy returns of the day.
And, thank you.
And what's the best gift you got for this birthday?
A lot of love, collective. I took photographs of almost 3,000 people lined up in my street.
So here. Yeah, Vandana from Film India, sir. I wanted to know, sir, India is like mostly into Bollywood music. It's very popular. But what's the future that you see in this English music? Will it capture the market? Because in between, there was a lot of demand for indie pop music. But that craze just got down. And now,
it needs to be helped. It needs to be nurtured. Nothing is wrong with, film music. It's beautiful, but it's been commissioned. Yes. Like, you have to write for the situation. And those are limited. Yeah. I think here, your imagination is... No, you can, the whole universe is your imagination. And sometimes, indie music actually inspires movies. I want that to happen. I want a song from here to go there. I mean, not a compulsion, but I felt like
that would be great.
This will open up. People's minds should never be closed. I think it should trigger the imagination of a common man. And that could only happen if you're not restricted in your imagination, that you should only write for this actor or actress or this story or this director. But here you can talk about anything. And, yeah.
You see the future bright for such music, sir?
Future is always bright. We actually create the future. All of us create the future.
We need a market first.
That's what we are trying to create. Yes. But for everything needs a first step. First steps are already there. Tiny steps are already there. Not denying that people are working towards this. I think we should collectively come and make this a success.
Thank you.
Hi, Mr. Rahman. I'm Riddhi from Rolling Stone India. And you mentioned K-pop earlier. I write about K-pop, so I had to ask you. What about the K-pop industry made you sort of notice it and look into it? And what can we in our Indian industry implement and learn from it?
India's the most young country now, and that's a gift and a curse. If it's guided correctly, and if we all have positive, thinking, I think we can go forward. But if we pull ourselves down, it's a bad thing. And each one of us have to push the way India is being projected and how India should be a success story for the world to see. And I feel music is a great tool for that. And so we're beginning now.
Is the entire visuals of it what we need to enhance as well, because in terms of packaging and things like that?
Sometimes, these details don't matter. Mm-hmm. Collectively, something should create an impact. And whatever it takes, we all have it. We have the resources, and we just need the intention. Intention is the most important thing.
Thank you. Anyone else?
Samir? So I just want to have a question regarding, so who are going to be the jury members? There are a lot of entries going to be, or there are going to be any international jury members also be participating it for judging and all.
So you saw on the panel, there's Uday, there's Nikhil, there's Clinton, there's Anushka, and of course, Rahman-san. So all of the content is actually going to is while they're also creating original music themselves, they're also going to be reviewing all of this content. So they are going to, you know, this jury sometimes creates this divide between artists and the actual people there. So we want them as the idea that came from out of Nexa Music was to have them as mentor collaborators. And so as mentor collaborators, they're of course reviewing stuff and helping it get better, but they're also going to be doing the job of the curation aspect. And this is where some of our, we're also looking, leaning onto the Rolling Stone magazine and the entire team over there to help us co-curate this so that we have one level of sift. The second level of sift comes in with all of these amazing artists. And then of course, everything that actually comes out is under the purview of Mr. Rahman also.
Okay, so are you seeing any kind of an international mentor from internationals, junior members?
There will be.
Don't want to reveal too
because
much.
Because the
on
most, and to focus on music and how it could probably nurture and how it could blossom is A&R. People who understand whether they have something beautiful already to realize it. Because sometimes you have something beautiful and you don't understand, you just throw it away. And you know, many, even abroad, I've heard many stories where people have had songs. James Blunt had that song for like years, the beautiful, and then somebody else took it and it became a big hit. It sometimes it takes time for people to understand that you follow the current trend and you think that this is the song because it sounds like what I've heard. And very few people have that imagination to find or realize what special has come in. And so it's a tricky part. We're all a team and we hope we don't do that mistake.
Thank you.
I just want to also add that I think while we'd welcome potentially an international collaboration or an influence, this team is in no means lacking whatever energy, inspiration, exposure that they can bring to the table, starting with Mr. Rahman. And you know, if you look at the, and we talked about some of the international journeys that some of these artists have had. I think at Nexa Music, there was a lot of time and energy spent in curating a panel and not necessarily going with who's the, you know, who would attract the most eyeballs. I think it's quite apparent that it's been curated from a purpose perspective of what they can give back. And so while we'd welcome anything that might come from the international audience, you know, an international collaborator, I think we're a very, very tight, capable team.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, Mr. Kalsi. I'm Bijoya from AdGully. I just wanted to check, why does Nexa feel there is a need for associating with music? And what does it bring to the table for a brand like Maruti and Nexa? And what is Kyuki's role in this entire exercise, so to say? And why Kyuki? Okay.
That's a number of questions, you know.
Yeah.
So, okay, going one by one. When we launched Nexa 5 years ago, our philosophy was to bring an international experience to our discerning customers, the young age customers, who have the exposure, you know, of say international travel, international class hospitality, international banking, you know. So this is a new, you know, class of our customers. And with the launch of Nexa, we just reinforced that, you know, philosophy that the customer should be pampered. He should have international kind of, you know, car buying experience. Now, Nexa is not just, you know, selling of cars. Nexa is about, say, cars, yes, but it's also about lifestyle, it's also about fashion, and music naturally comes through, you know, that kind of lifestyle. And also, when a person is driving the car today, maybe he spends anything between 1 hour to 2 hours to his workplace in the morning and evening, so that's the best time when he can enjoy music. So that kind of association we are working on. And when it comes to music and for Nexa, we thought that it has to be of international class. And we have to have, you know, get association with the, you know, best team and the best mentor. Then who else other than, you know, Mr. A.R. Rahman and his company, Kyuki.
Thank you.
Yeah. My question is Samir. Samir over here. Yeah, Samir. Just you mentioned that there'll be a live gigs after this thing. Just want to know that this will be performed abroad also, and we'll be there like Rahman sir and Nikhil Uday.